In this lesson, I'm going to help you understand balance scales in math, and I'm going to focus on the balance scales, the scales that can be balanced using addition or subtraction. For this lesson, I'm going to introduce you to the balance scale, and I'm also going to show you balance scales that use addition to balance out. I'm also going to show you scales that use subtraction to get balanced out, and then we will look at some examples together and show you how to apply the concepts that we've learned to actual examples. Now let's look at the balance scale. For a scale to be balanced, you have two quantities, you have the same quantity of value on both sides, almost like a seesaw. So if you look at this example, for example here, you have 4 on this side, you have 9 on this side. So a balance scale should never have one side greater than the other side. So this example here is this one we'll call this unbalanced because you have 9 on one side and you have 4 on the other side. Now this other scale here, you have 4 and 5. So if you add these numbers together, you have 9. So this is an example of what the balance scale is. And when it's balanced, you have the equal to sign because the equal to sign tells us that the quantity on the left-hand side and the quantity on the right-hand side have the same value. Now let's look at balancing scales using addition. So to balance scales using addition, you have to add a quantity to one side to make it have so that it has the same value as the quantity on the right-hand side. So, and it could be either way. So as long as the two quantities have the same side and you have to add to one side to level it up with the other side, you have an addition balance scale. So let's look at this for example. So we have 3 on this on the left-hand side, and we have an unknown quantity here, and you have the equal to sign here. This tells us that they have to be balanced. That's what this equal to sign actually indicates. And now we have a 7 on the right-hand side. So the question you want to ask yourself is, what do I need to add to this left-hand side to level it up with the right-hand side? And the answer to that is 4, because if you add 3 and 4, you have 7. Now, when we have a balance scale that requires subtraction, or a scale that requires subtraction to get it balanced, you have a quantity on one side that is greater than the quantity on the other side. So here in this example, we have 12 and an unknown quantity, and then we have 8 on the other side. What do I need to do with 12 to reduce it to 8? So you can see here that there's a reduction that needs to happen to get to 8. So what do you do to 12 to get it to 8? You subtract 4 from 12 and you get to 8. So 12 minus 4 is going to give you 8. So now this scale has been balanced using subtraction. Now we're going to go ahead and look at some examples together. So find the value of the unknown quantity in the scale below. So we have 2 on the left-hand side and we have an unknown quantity and we have 8 on the right-hand side. How would we go ahead and get the value that we need to add to 2 to get 8? The simple way to do that is 8 minus 2. It's going to give you 6. So this is going to be plus 6 on this side. I'm going to add 6 to 2 to get us to 8. The next example, find the unknown quantity in the scale below. So we have 4 and 9. So 4 plus 9, I have 13 on this side. And then I need a quantity to add to 7 to get it to 13. So I'll just go ahead and subtract 7 from 13. And that's going to give me plus 6 right here. So I need to add 6 units here to get it balanced with the left-hand side. Find the value of the unknown quantity in the scale below. So on the left-hand side, I have 5 plus 4 plus 9, and that's going to give me 18. On the right-hand side, I have 13 and an unknown quantity. What do I need to add to 13 to make it 18? So I just have to subtract 18 from, I have to subtract 13 from 18. So this is going to give me 5. So I'm adding 5 to 13 to get it to 18. And then our final example, Find the value of the unknown quantity in the scale below. So now I have 5 and an unknown quantity on the left-hand side, and I have 2 on the right-hand side. We can see here that this side right here is 5 is a larger value than 2. So what do I need to do with 5 to reduce it to 2? So let's look at this right here. 5 minus 2 is going to give me 3. So what I need to do is I need to reduce this side by 3 units so I can get to this side. So I'm subtracting 3 from 5 so I can get to 2. This is how you work with balance skills using addition or subtraction.